Now we are discussing about pressure energy per unit mass and pressure energy per unit volume. So what is the pressure energy? If you create any kind of pressure on the fluid, that is converting into energy. We are applying pressure means definitely it is exerting some force. Due to that force, what happens? We are doing some work externally. How much external work you are doing, we are doing, that converting into energy. How much energy we are applied mechanically outside, that much energy liquid possesses, liquid gains. So for example, from outside I am applying 2 joules work I am doing by applying some force. Force means your pressure only creating some force. Due to that, for example, 2 joules work I had done. Work and energy units same only. So 2 joules work you are doing means 2 joules energy possessed by that liquid due to our external mechanical work. So that is called pressure energy. So what is the pressure energy? Work done by which work? External work. External work done by the pressure. External work done by the pressure is converted into external work done by the pressure is giving some energy to the liquid. So liquid possesses some energy. So liquid possesses or gains equal to energy. Equal to how much work we have done. That much equal energy it is possessing. So liquid possesses or gains equal energy. This is called pressure energy. This is called pressure energy. This is called pressure energy. So that is the definition to pressure energy. So for example, I am taking one cylindrical vessel. At the bottom I am keeping one side tube. Here we are applying some force. Force means area of cross section of this piston I am taking small a. Here what is the small a? Small a is the area of cross section. And what is the P? External pressure I am applying by using piston. So due to this, it had possessed delta x displacement. Pressure means definitely it is exerting some force. Due to that some force, that piston travels delta x displacement. So force applied, displacement came. So definitely what is there? Some work is there. So how much work we had done? That work only converting into energy to the liquid. So that is called pressure energy. So first you find the energy. Pressure energy first you find. After only pressure energy per unit mass. Again pressure energy per unit volume. Okay, now first I am finding work. How much work we are doing here? That work only energy due to pressure. So now we are having one formula for pressure. What is the formula for pressure? Pressure equal to, what is the formula for pressure? Pressure equal to force by area. Pressure is denoted with P. That equal to force by area. Force by area. Force is denoted with F, area with A. So what we had got here, P equal to F by A. Okay, now I am taking cross multiplication. Then what happens? F equal to P into A. So this is my force. You are applying some pressure on some area of cross section. Okay, this area of cross section you take capital A. Anyway you take, if it is small a, here also we are taking small a, that things later. Okay, now how much force applied? P into A. due to this, I displace liquid. Initial liquid is here. So from here to here, I am displacing. So how much displacement? Delta X. Now I am doing some work. That work only converting into energy. So now what is the work? Work equal to force into displacement. Force F into displacement. Work equal to force into displacement. That is the formula. So what is the force? F. Okay, and what is the displacement? Delta X. So this is my work. That only energy. But here we are doing force. What is the force? When we are applying that force, here how much liquid traveling that we are taking. Okay, now F equal to what we are taking some? F equal to P into A. Now we write this. So what we are writing here? W equal to P into A into delta X. You take this is third equation. Here what is the A? Area of cross section. Delta X is what? Displacement. So area of cross section and here displacement means like if you assume this is like a cylinder. Here A is the area of cross section and delta X is the length. Pi r square h. Pi r square means A. H means delta X. So this represents what? Volume. So what is the volume? A into delta X. Here if it is useful or not useful later things, that is the concept. So delta V equal to A into delta X. So delta V volume displaced due to our external pressure. Okay, now work completed. Work means energy completed. Not only pressure energy. Now I want to find per unit mass. Now I want to go to pressure energy per unit mass. Now, pressure energy per unit mass. Pressure energy per unit mass. Pressure energy per unit mass. Okay, now what is the energy? P into A into delta X. By what is the mass? Due to this displacement, how much mass transferred? I am assuming M mass transferred. M is small. Delta M mass transferred. So, from here to here piston came. So, this is how much mass of the water is there that is going inside to the jar. So, what is the formula for mass? Mass equal to volume into density. So, that how much volume here I have taken? A into delta X. So, P into A into delta X. What is the formula for mass? Volume into density. So, delta V into density I am taking as rho. What is the rho? Density of the liquid. So, here you write all the things clearly. So, density equal to mass by volume. That is the formula. Density means I am taking rho. Mass means M. Volume means V. So, what happens here? M equal to V into rho. M equal to V into rho. That is the general formula for any case. Here, M means delta M. So, V means delta V. If it is small thing, this also small thing. Density constant. So, if it is small thing, what happens? Delta M happens. So, delta M equal to delta V into rho. Rho is constant. If you are sending small liquid or more amount of liquid, density of the liquid constant only. So, remain. If it is small, this also small. If this is big, this also big. Like that. Delta represents small thing. Okay, now what happens here? Here, delta V. What about delta V? A into delta X. I had already wrote. So, now you write this. That equal to P into A into delta X by what about delta V? A into delta X into rho. So, A cancel, delta X cancel. Now, P by rho. P by rho is called pressure energy per unit mass. What is that? Pressure energy per unit mass. This is called pressure energy. P by rho is called pressure energy per unit mass. unit mass. Total pressure by total mass. That gives what? Unit mass. Pressure energy per unit mass. P by rho. Remember that. P by rho is called pressure energy per unit mass. Similarly, I am going to pressure energy per unit volume. Basic that only from that only. Once you see all the things. How we had found pressure energy per unit mass. After that, we are going to pressure energy per unit volume. After this, we are going to pressure energy per unit volume. So, that is pressure energy per unit mass. Next, you go to pressure energy per unit volume. Now, unit volume means what we are taking here? Total volume taking. In this case, we are taking total volume. Then only it comes as a unit volume. So, total pressure by total volume. So, that gives pressure energy per unit volume. Okay. Now we are going to pressure energy per unit volume. Next thing is pressure energy per unit volume. Pressure energy per unit volume. What is the pressure energy? Energy work. P into A into delta X. By how much volume transferred when we are pushing? Delta V. So what I wrote delta V? P into A into delta X. And all I wrote delta V equal to A into delta X. So A into delta X. Delta X cancel, A cancel. So pressure energy per unit volume, that is called P. Pressure energy per unit mass is P by rho. Per unit volume is P. So, by using this concept only, we are explaining Bernoulli's theorem. So, once you see how it came. Pressure energy per unit mass and pressure energy per unit volume. So, this is about energy, pressure energy.